गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज हेलोरकेन्स एंड हेलोरिंग्स। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन एंड द नोमेनक्लेचर इन्वॉल्व्ड इन द हेलोरकेन्स एंड हेलोरिंग्स। सो फर्स्टली आई एम स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम हेलोरकेन्स। सो व्हाट आर हेलोरकेन्स? आई एम स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम हेलोरकेन्स। सो व्हाट आर हेलोरकेन्स? Haloalkanes are nothing but the derivatives of alkanes. So they are the derivatives of alkanes. Okay, so haloalkanes are the derivatives of alkane. We all know the general formula for alkane is RH. The general formula for alkane is RH, and if I replace this hydrogen with any X group, then we will get RX, and if this X group is any of the halogen group, okay, if this X group is any of the halogen group, then this RX constitute a new class of compounds known as haloalkanes, known as haloalkanes or alkyl halides. Okay, so simply, for example, if we have methane, okay, if we have methane, and if I replace this hydrogen group with any of the, you can say, if I replace this with chlorine, then we will get CH3Cl. And this is known as chloromethane. This is known as chloromethane or methyl chloride. Similarly, we will get fluoromethane, methyl fluoride, bromomethane, methyl bromide, okay, iodomethane, methyl iodide. Okay, so, and what are haloarenes? What are halorings? So if halogen group is directly attached to a aromatic system, then that class of compounds are known as halorings. For example, if we have a benzene ring, we all know there are 6 hydrogen atoms in a benzene ring. Okay, if I replace any of the hydrogen atom from a benzene ring, then we will get with any X group, where X group is any of the halogen group out of these 4. So we will get this group, and this compound is known as haloarenes. ठीक है, this is a new class of compounds known as haloarenes. ठीक है, so okay, so if we have this compound, we all know this compound is known as toluene. This compound is known as toluene. If I replace this hydrogen with any of the X group, so if I replace this hydrogen with any of the X group, then this is also known as haloalkanes. Why it is not a haloarene? It is also a haloalkane. Why it is not a haloarene? Because in this compound, the halogen is not directly attached to the aromatic ring. In this compound, the halogen is attached to a carbon which is present in the side chain. Okay, so in this compound, the halogen is attached to a carbon which is present in the side chain, not directly attached. Okay, so if I replace this hydrogen with any of the halogen group, then this is known as haloarene. Then this is a haloarene, because here the halogen group is directly attached to the benzene ring. Okay, so what are haloalkanes? Haloalkanes are the derivatives of alkanes. Okay, so what are halorenes? Halorenes are the new class of compounds in which halogen is directly attached to aromatic system. Okay, it is directly attached. So this is all about haloalkanes and halorenes. एक बार आप इसे नोट कर लें, देन वी विल प्रोसीड फर्दर. सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड व्हाट आर हैलोएल्केन्स एंड हैलोरीन्स. सो लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ हैलोएल्केन्स और हैलोरीन्स. सो फर्स्टली आई एम स्टार्टिंग विद द ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ number of halogen groups. On the basis of number of halogen groups attached, they are further classified on the basis of number of halogen groups attached or the number of hydrogen groups replaced. ठीक है. So if we have a methane group, okay, if I replace one fluorine, then we will get CH3Cl. And this is known as chloromethane. Okay. If I replace two chlorine atoms, then we will get CH2Cl2. And this is known as dichloromethane. Okay. Similarly, if I replace three hydrogen, then we will get CHCl3. And the common name for this compound is chloroform, and the IUPAC name is trichloromethane. Similarly, if I replace four hydrogen with four chlorine group, then we will get CCl4, and the common name for this compound is tetrachloromethane. And the common name is carbon tetrachloride. This is the common name, carbon tetrachloride, and tetrachloromethane is the IUPAC name. And CCl4 is a very good non-polar solvent. So in a large number of reactions we require non-polar solvent, then this CCl4 is a very good option, ठीक है, for those reactions in which we will require non-polar solvent, ठीक है. Similarly, if I replace one hydrogen, then we will get with any chlorine group, then this is known as chlorobenzene. Now, if I replace the second hydrogen, so we have three options. Okay, the first is if I replace the next hydrogen from the second carbon atom. Okay, if I replace the hydrogen atom from second carbon atom, then this is known as ortho dichlorobenzene. The common name is ortho dichlorobenzene, or we can say 1,2 dichlorobenzene. Similarly, we have two more options, like if I replace the hydrogen from the third carbon atom, then this is known as the common name is meta dichlorobenzene, or 1,3-dichlorobenzene. ठीक है. And similarly, if we replace the second hydrogen from the fourth place, then we will get then we will get this compound, okay, known as para dichlorobenzene or 1,4-dichlorobenzene. So this is the first type of classification on the basis of number of halogen groups attached. So similarly, we will have trichlorobenzene, ठीक है, we will also check how many number of you can say isomers are possible in case of trichlorobenzene. So itna aap note kar le, then we will proceed further. So we have already discussed what are haloalkanes and halogens, and we have already classified haloalkanes on the basis of number of halogen atoms attached. So if we have the two halogen atoms attached to the same carbon atom, then this will constitute a new class of compounds known as geminal dichlorides. So in this case we have geminal dichloride. Okay, so what are geminal dichloride, or you can say the geminal halides? Geminal dihalides. What are geminal dihalides? In the dihalides in which the halogen atom is directly attached to, if both the halogen atoms are attached to the same carbon atom, then this is known as geminal dihalide. For example, we have this compound. Okay, so here this is also known as geminal dichloride. Okay, so similarly this is the, you can say, the common IUPAC nomenclature. So these are known as gem, we have to write it as gem dichloride, okay, or gem ethyl dichloride. Okay, so we have to write it as gem ethyl dichloride or gem methyl dichloride. So in common name they are written as alkylidene chlorides, or you can say alkylidene halides. ठीक है, this this edene group tells us that we have two halogen groups, ठीक है, which are present on the same carbon atoms. That is why I have not written here di, ठीक है. So IDENE से पता हमें चल रहा है कि the both groups are attached to the same carbon atoms, ठीक है. So so the name of this compound will be ethylidene chloride. In some of the books they have also written dichlorides, but there is no need to write dichloride here, because IDENE group already simplifies it that we have two halogen groups attached to the same carbon atom. Similarly, we have vicinal dihalides. We will also have vicinal dihalides. So now what are vicinal dihalides? So vicinal dihalides are those in which the two halogen atoms are attached to the adjacent carbon atoms. ठीक है? For example, we have this compound. ठीक है? For example, we have this compound. This is known as vicinal dichloride. ठीक है? So, and the common name is alkylene. ठीक है? Alkylene dichloride. Here we have to write the word the dichloride also, ठीक है, और alkylene dihalides in general form. We have alkylene dihalides. So the common name for this compound will be ethylene dichloride. Ethylene dichloride. So these are also the two special nomenclature, ठीक है, based on the position of the, you can say, the halogen groups. If they are attached to the same carbon atom, if the two vacancies are you can say satisfied by the same carbon atom, then this is known as geminal or gem dihalides. And if the two halogen atoms are attached to the adjacent carbon atom, if the two halogens are attached to the adjacent carbon atom, then they are known as vicinal, or you can say weak dihalides. ठीक है, so this is known as vicinal ethyl, you can say dichloroethane. ठीक है, Similarly, here we have you can say gem dichloroethane. ठीक है, so these two are the two different types of dihalides. So ये आप नोट कर लें. Then we will proceed to the trihalides. So let's move on to the tri you can say the halides. ठीक है, so if we have a benzene ring, then how many we have to write the number of trihalides which are possible. So there are total 3 trihalides which are possible. The first one is, if I replace 3 hydrogen atom with 3 bromine, then the first, you can say the first type is 1, 2, 3. Okay, the first is 1, 2, 3 tribromo benzene. Okay, 1, 2, 3 tribromo benzene. ठीक है, दिस इज द फर्स्ट आइसोमर. एंड द सेकंड इज ओके, द सेकंड आइसोमर विल बी 1, 2, 4. ओके, सो दिस इज द सेकंड टाइप ऑफ आइसोमर विच कैन बी फॉर्म 1, 2, 4 ट्राई ब्रोमो बेंजीन. ठीक है, एंड द थर्ड वन इज 1, 3, 5 tribromo benzene. Okay, so these are the 3 possible you can say isomers in case of tribromo benzene. ठीक है, so the first one is 1, 2, 3 tribromo benzene, the second is 1, 2, 4 tribromo benzene, and the third one is 1, 3, 5 tribromo benzene, which is also known as SIM, which is also known as SIM tribromo benzene. ठीक है, here SIM is representing the symmetry, because this compound is symmetrical. ठीक है, so because it have a center of symmetry over here. ठीक है, because it have a center of symmetry, that is why it is known as SIM tribromo benzene. So let's move on to the second type of classification on the basis of the hybridization, or you can say the bonding between the carbon and the halogen atom. So the next type is on the basis of hybridization. So I'm starting from sp3 hybridized carbon. So if the carbon atom is sp3 hybridized, then we have already discussed that for example, if we have this compound, so here the carbon atom is sp3 because there are all single bonds present. ठीक है, similarly if we have this compound. ठीक है, so here this carbon atom is sp3 hybridized. ठीक है, so this is the type, this is sp3 type of haloalkenes. ठीक है, so similarly we also have a special type of compound known as allyl compounds. ठीक है, so we also have a new class of compounds known as allylic compounds, or you can say allyl compounds. So the compounds in which the carbon atom to which the halogen is attached is adjacent to a carbon-carbon double bond. Like we have, for example, if we have this compound, ठीक है, so here the carbon atom to which the halogen is attached is adjacent to a carbon-carbon double bond, सो दीज टाइप ऑफ कंपाउंड्स आर क्लासिफाइड एज एलाइलिक कंपाउंड्स, ठीक है. और वी कैन से दिस ग्रुप इज नोन एज एलाइलिक ग्रुप, ठीक है. सो दीज टाइप ऑफ कंपाउंड्स आर क्वाइट स्पेशल. सो एक तो ये कि इफ वी रिप्लेस दिस क्लोरीन एटम एंड वी विल गेट पॉजिटिव चार्ज हियर, देन दिस पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड दिस डबल बॉन्ड कम यू कैन से अंडरगो रेजोनेंस, ठीक है, लाइक दिस. सो दैट इज व्हाई दे आर रेजोनेंस स्टेबलाइज्ड. सो दिस प्रॉपर्टी इज ऑल्सो यूज्ड इन सम रिएक्शंस ऑल्सो इन द रिएक्शन मैकेनिज्म. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ कंपाउंड्स आर नोन एज एलाइलिक कंपाउंड्स. सो द सेकेंड टाइप ऑफ स्पेशल कंपाउंड्स आर बेंजाइलिक कंपाउंड. सिमिलरली वी हैव बेंजाइलिक कंपाउंड्स इन विच द कार्बन एटम to which the halogen is attached is further attached to a benzene ring. If the carbon atom is attached to a benzene ring, okay, then this this is known as benzyl compounds, okay, and this compound is known as benzyl chloride, okay. Similarly, this compound is known as allyl chloride, or you can say, okay. So this compound is known as benzyl chloride. So the compounds in which, so, and this is also a very special type of compound, because here also if we replace this chlorine atom we will get positive charge here, and this positive charge and the double bonds, or you can say the pi bonds undergo resonance with each other. So that is why we will get a double bond character over here, okay. So if we will get a double bond character over here, okay, due to resonance. So they are also considered as special type of compound, okay. So let's move on to sp2 hybridized. So what are sp2 hybridized compounds, okay? So in which the carbon atom is directly attached to a carbon which is sp2 in nature, okay. For example, if we have this type of compound, okay, here the carbon atom, you can say the halogen atom is directly attached to a carbon which is sp2 hybridized. This carbon is sp2 hybridized, and this type of compounds are known as vinylic compounds, okay. So what are vinylic compounds? Vinylic compounds are those compounds in which the halogen atom is directly attached to a sp2 hybridized carbon, okay, in which the halogen atom is directly attached to a sp2 hybridized carbon. So these are known as vinylic compounds. For example, we have CH2 double bond CH. So this is a vinyl group. Similarly, if we have this compound, so here the halogen atom is directly attached to a carbon which is sp2 hybridized, then this is also a vinylic compound. Vinylic halo alkene, ठीक है, sorry alkene, ठीक है. So this is known as vinylic group, ठीक है. So similarly, we also have sp hybridized, ठीक है. So in this type of compound, the halogen group is directly attached to a sp carbonate, ठीक है, like this. So we have a sp hybridized carbon, ठीक है. So on the basis of hybridization we have sp3 hybridized halo, ठीक है, halogens, you can say alkyl halides, and sp2 and sp, ठीक है. So these are further classified as primary, secondary and tertiary. So let's look into it. So what is meant by primary, secondary or tertiary, or you can say 1 degree, 2 degree or 3 degree halo alkenes, ठीक है. So let's move on to primary, secondary and tertiary. So we have primary, secondary and tertiary, or we can say 1 degree, 2 degree or 3 degree, ठीक है, and 3 degree compound. So if the carbon atom to which the halogen is attached is further attached to only a single carbon atom, then this is then it is termed as primary. If it is further attached to two carbon atom, then it is known as secondary. And if it is further attached to three carbon atom, then it is termed as tertiary. So for example, if we have this carbon, this compound, so here the carbon atom is attached to only a single carbon atom, then it is known as primary. And if it is attached to two carbon atoms like this, then it is termed as secondary. And if it is attached to three carbon atoms, then it is termed as tertiary. ठीक है? So if the carbon atom to which halogen is attached to a single carbon atom, then it is termed as primary. Or you can say the carbon to which the halogen is attached is primary. ठीक है? Similarly, if the carbon atom is attached further to two carbon atoms, then it is known as secondary. And if the carbon atom is attached to three carbon atoms, then it is termed as tertiary. Okay. So now I am writing some examples. So let's say we have this compound. We all know this is a allylic group. If I replace this hydrogen with a CH3 group, then this is 2-degree allylic group and this is 2-degree allylic group. ठीक है? And if I replace the second hydrogen also, then it will become a 3-degree allylic group. ठीक है? Then it will become a 3-degree allylic group. ठीक है? Similarly, we have benzyl. Similarly, we have benzyl over here. So if we have benzyl, ठीक है? So if we have benzyl, this is benzyl. If I replace this hydrogen with any of the alkyl group, then this is 2-degree benzyl, or you can say this is benzyl. ठीक है? The common name is benzyl. ठीक है? 2-degree benzylic group is also known as benzyl. 2-degree benzyl. And if I replace the second hydrogen also with any of the alkyl group, then this is known as benzo, benzo. ठीक है? And this is known as 3-degree benzylic. ठीक है? So this is all about primary, secondary and tertiary. So now I am writing some compounds or the structure of some compounds, and you have to tell me whether it is primary, secondary or tertiary. So pause the video and try to solve these problems, and you have to tell me which one is primary, secondary or tertiary. So let's start from the A part. So here you can say halogen is attached to this carbon, which is further attached to two carbon atoms, so it is 2-degree, or we can say it is secondary. And here also the carbon atom to which iodine is attached is further attached to two carbon atoms, then it is also considered as secondary. And in C part, the carbon atom to which halogen is further attached to 1, 2 and 3, so it is tertiary. And in this case, the carbon atom to which halogen is attached is further attached to three carbon atom, then it is also considered as tertiary. And now in this case, so this is a bridged compound, and in this case the iodine is attached to this carbon atom, which is further attached to 1, 2 and this three carbon atom, so it is also termed as tertiary. And again in this case, okay, similar to the previous one, this carbon atom is further attached to 1, 2 and 3, and it is also your tertiary. And in this case, this carbon atom is attached to 2 carbon atoms, and it is termed as secondary. So, in this case, this carbon atom, okay, is attached to further 2 carbon atom, then it is also secondary. And in this case, the carbon atom to which halogen is attached is further attached to only one carbon atom, then it is primary. And in the last one, J part, In this, the carbon atom to which chlorine is attached is further attached to 1, 2 and 3. 3 carbon atom. Then it is termed as then it is termed as 3 degree, that is tertiary. So, this is all about the primary, secondary and tertiary. So, in this lecture, I think this is enough for this particular lecture. And in the next lecture, we will discuss some more examples related to the nomenclature. So, we will discuss some more new terms, like we have ISO, NEO, ठीक है? Some common terms which are also important for the board exam as well as the competitive exams, ठीक है? So, in competitive exams, common names are generally asked by the examiners, ठीक है? So, they are also quite important. So, thank you so much. Stay safe and keep learning.